So in previous class we have seen about the conductivity expression sigma is equal to ne square t by m, and even we have seen the expression for the drift speed and the relation between drift speed and electric current also present. And let me discuss what are the limitations of the Ohm's law. Is it limitations of limitations of Ohm's? What are limitations? Ohm's law. According to Ohm's law, the potential difference applied increases, the current flowing through that conductor also increases. That means the current flowing through a conductor is directly proportional to the potential difference applied across the same, provided temperature and physical conditions remains constant. Now, for this one, Ohm's law is applicable only for good conductors. Is it? Ohm's law applicable only for good conductors. Applicable only for good conductors, metallic conductors. And for this metallic conductor, we varies potential difference. Current varies linearly. Varies linearly with the I potential difference, which are. But it does not applicable for at very low voltages and at very low temperatures and high temperature. That is what when we have to find. A potential difference, Ohm's law is applicable only for constant and at constant temperatures, and even whenever the physical conditions remains constant. Is it okay? That is what not applicable yet very low and very high temperatures. Very high temperatures. And V does not vary with I linearly. Let us take for vacuum tubes. Is it? Or even semiconductors. V does not vary linearly. So that is what the variation of the current will be depends upon the sign of V, sign of. So variation of current is not say with V. So how it happens? Variation of the current is not same with V. So V is not, I is not unity with V. Problem. That is what it depends upon sign of V also. That means it depends on sign of V. Sign of V means, for example, if you are taken for semiconductors, diodes, what happens? As V value, I value. If the potential difference increases, the current will be increases in this manner. But if you, without changing its magnitude, but if you reverse the direction of the voltage, negative, instead of very high current to that battery, instead of positive negative and instead of negative positive, you have given. So what will happen? This is negative sign, minus. In that case, then this is not linear like this will happen. Is it? So the variation of the current is not in a cube as with the V, because with the sign it depends upon what sign. Even you can take for vacuum tubes, which is vacuum tubes, V and I vacuum tubes, remember which are nothing but, and even
the current will have, for same current will have two potentials like a gallium arsenide thing. Is it? Same current at different potentials. For example, if you are taking gallium arsenide. Gallium arsenide. For this one, current V. Look at this one. Sorry. Same current at different potentials. We have potential V1 and V2, but we have same current. At same current, we have different potentials. So, this is what the limitations of the Ohm's law. Remember, very, very important for 2 marks. Ohm's law is applied only for good conductors and does not vary. Applied only for good conductors when even physical conditions constant. Physical conditions means what? Physical conditions constant. Whenever physical condition means length or area of cross section, these things should be constant. And at very high temperature, low temperature is not applicable. And even the current is not an issue for the voltage. In the same, how you change the voltages in this manner? If you reverse in negative direction, if you reverse or if you change the voltages in negative direction, the variation of the current is not negative. Is it? That is what? And even it is the same, which is gallium arsenide, even for thermistor. So these are what the limitations. Let us see ohmic and non-ohmic conductors. Ohmic conductors are ohmic devices. What do you mean by ohmic devices? The conductors which obeys Ohm's law are conductors which obey Ohm's law are called ohmic devices or ohmic conductors. And for this, VI graph is linear. VI graph is linear. Linear means we get a straight line. We get straight line. Now remember, for this one, what is the slope of VI graph is different, IV graph is different. This is IV graph. IV graph. I value is on y axis and V values are y x axis. IV graph. Remember, velocity time graph. Position time graph line we have taken. Position time graph means what? Position on y axis and time is an x axis. Velocity on y axis and time is an x axis. Like that, I is on x y axis and potential difference is on y axis, then we call it as IV graph. Now, for IV graph, so what are examples? All conductors and electrolytes are moving. So IV graph and have taken slope of the IV graph is I by V. Look at this one, IV for IV. I by V is nothing but what? 1 by R1. So 1 by R is nothing but what? Conductance. Reciprocal of the resistance is called what? Conductance. Reciprocal of the resistance is what? Conductance. Even now. When you have taken, similarly, for VI graph means potential difference is on y axis, current is on x axis. For VI graph, slope of the VI graph gives what? VY, which is nothing but what? Resistance. And these are nothing but ohmic devices. Then what are non-ohmic conductors? Non-ohmic conductors. Non-ohmic conductors means the conductors which does not obey Ohm's law are called non-ohmic conductors. Conductors which do not obey Ohm's law are called conductors which do not obey Ohm's law are called non-Ohm conductors. For non-Ohm conductors, the graph is curved, not linear. Non-linear. Graph is what? Non-linear. Examples what I will have? Vacuum tubes. Vacuum tubes are diodes, transistors, diodes, transistors, and even thermostats. Thermistors. These are nothing but non-ohmic conductors. These are what? Limitations of most of what are ohmic and non-ohmic conductors. And what is the nature of the graph for ohmic conductors? Type in. For non-ohmic conductors, what is the nature of the graph? Curve or non-linear. So what are resistors already? What do you think? Resistor. Which are the resistors, which are the device which are opposes the, which oppose the flow of charges or flow of current in a resistor. How many types of the resistors we have? We have two types of resistors, which are carbon bound resistor, wire bound resistor and carbon resistors and wire bound resistors. In a wire bound resistor, a wire is winded around that one and it is formed as a resistor wire connector, and even and in this wire like a alloy like nickel or manganese, constantin, these are used as preparing the wire bond resistor. Whereas in carbon bond resistors, in these wire bond resistors, small values of the resistors, small magnitude of resistors used. Even for carbon resistors, we use not for a bigger values of the resistors to construct bigger values of resistors, we use this carbon resistors. Okay. Now, for identifying the resistance value, we have some color codes. And what are the color codes of the resistors? Color codes of resistors. Is it? Let me write here. B, B, Roy. Great Britain and very great wife. Even she wears gold, silver necklace. Is it? So what are the number and multiples we have? Multiple. Now look at this for B represents black, 0, 10 power 0, multiply. Is it? Similarly, brown, 1, then what is multiply? Decimal, 10 power. Is it? And red, 2, 10 power 2. And for orange, 3. Yellow, 4, is it? Green, 5, blue, 6, violet, 7, gray, 8, white, 9, is it? Whereas for gold, if you have gold color, and for this one, these are to represent 10 power minus 1. If these for what? 10 power 3, 10 power 4, multiple, is it? Here also 10 power 5, here are 10 power 6, 10 power 7, here it is 10 power 8, for this one are 10 power 7. Whereas gold, silver, for silver it is 10 power minus 2. And necklace means no color, it is no color. This is what tolerance, we have to see tolerance. Tolerance means varies in the resistance. Here 5%, 10%, 20%. So what is fourth color? Gold, silver. For gold color means tolerance 5%. Silver color tolerance is what? 10%. For no color is what? 20%. Let us see how to calculate, how to find this resistance by using this code. What is the code here? Remember, B.B. Roy as a name. B.B. Roy. Great Britain versus Great White. And she wears gold necklace, gold silver necklace. B.B. Roy, Great Britain versus Great White. B.B. Roy, Great Britain versus Great White. Is it? Let us see example. How do you find? For a resistor, we'll have four colors for representing. Four square shape colors, square shape, circular rings of the color. Here 1, 2, 3, 4. Is it? 1, 2, 3, 4. From left to right, the colors are we have to locate. For example, first two colors will be two significant digits of that resistor. Is it? First two colors. What? Two digits of resistor. Two digits of resistor. And third color gives the decimal multiples of the 10 power. This is what multiplier of this. And fourth color gives the tolerance. Fourth color gives what? Tolerance. Fourth color gives what? Tolerance. Now look at here. What? How to find? Let me take one example. If it is red, yellow, orange, and this is silver. Red, orange, silver colors are indicated like that. Then what is the resistance? Alpha is what? Red, yellow, and O is for what? Orange. Y for what? Fourth color is what? Silver. Now what is the rule? First two colors gives two digits of the resistor, two significant digits. Now what we have here? Red and yellow. Red color is what? Red, what is the symbol? Red 2. Whereas yellow is what? 4. Then you write 2, 4. So I say 24 into third color represents what? Multiplier, decimal multiplier. So decimal is what? For orange color is what? 3. Then what you have here? 24 into 10 power 3. Now fourth color represents what? Tolerance. What do you mean by the tolerance? Tolerance means because of the change in temperature, the value of the resistance may be changes, increases or decreases. That we discuss now. Is it? How much will be changes because of the temperature? That is also can be find by using this color code easily. Now plus or minus varies. It is what? Ohm plus or minus. Silver is what? Silver is 10%. 10% tolerance. Is it? That represents, for example, what is this value? 24 kilo. 24 kilo means 24,000 ohm. That tolerance is 10% means. What is 10% of this one? R is equal to. Then delta R may be 24,000 into 10%. 10 by 100. Or 0. This one value. Then what is this value? 2400. Right. Therefore, 24 kilo ohm 24 into 10 power 3 plus or minus 2400 ohm. So what will be the vary resistance values where will be varies plus for 2400 or minus 24000 plus 2400 26400 ohm or 24000 minus 24000 minus 2400 006 31 21600. Therefore, the resistance values will be varies from 21,600 ohm to 26,400. This is what tolerance, that is what the meaning of it. 10% may be more or less, that is what. Yeah. Similarly, let us see one more example so that you can understand easily. Let me discuss one more example. Violate brown blue and gold. What is this? Violet represents your violet 7, brown, black, brown 0, 1 into 10 power brown blue. What is blue? 6. Then 10 power 6 plus or minus gold. What is your tolerance for gold? 5%. Is it? Sir, what is that? Now I will give the value of resistor. You find a corresponding to that. Is it? 1200 kilo ohm plus or minus 20%. 1200 kilo ohm plus or minus 20%. Now how do you write? Find colors of that resistance. Then what is 1200 into kilo 10 power 3. So that represents what we have 12 into 10 power 5. 12 into 10 power 5. Is it 12? What represents? 1 is what here? 1 is element brown. So first color is what? Brown. Next. 2. 2 represents what? Red. 2 represents what? Red. Brown. Red. Next. 10 power 5. 5 represents what here? Green. Is it? 5 represents green. Dark color represents the whereas 20%. 20% represents fourth, there is no color. Only we have four colors. Three colors. This is what? Carbon resistor. How many colors are there? Three colors. Here, no color resistor. Then what is this color? First one, brown. Second color is what? Red. And this is what here? Green. So depending upon that colors, you need to identify the resistance value by using this color. Is it? How is the resistivity of the conductors or insulators or even semiconductors? How it varies with the temperature? Let us discuss. So what would be happening? The change in resistivity per unit resistance is called temperature coefficient of the resistivity. Resistivity, variation of the resistivity. Remember, the resistivity value for metals is very less, so that the conductivity is more. It is around 10 power minus 2 to 10 power minus 8 ohm meter. Whereas for semiconductors, it is around 10 power minus 5 to 10 power 6 ohm meter. Whereas for insulators, it is more. Insulators, 10 power 8 into 10 power 21 ohmic. This value may be varies 10 power 11 to 10 power 18. Is it? 10 power 11 to 10 power 18 or 10 power 7 to 10 power. There is no particular rigid fixed boundary. Is it? Slightly it will be changed. So what would happen? What is the changing? Let us say a temperature, resistivity at any temperature, resistivity at any temperature rho T. If it is resistivity at 0 degree Celsius is rho naught. Now the change in resistivity is directly proportional to the change in temperature. And even it is directly proportional to the initial resistivity. Therefore, we can write here rho T minus rho naught is equal to exactly proportional to rho naught into delta T. Is it okay? Therefore, by doing this proportionality constant, rho T minus rho naught is equal to alpha rho naught into delta T, where alpha is called temperature coefficient of resistivity, where alpha is equal to constant for a particular metal, which is rho T minus rho naught by rho naught into delta T. This is called temperature coefficient of resistivity. Temperature coefficient of resistivity. Temperature coefficient of resistivity. How can you define temperature coefficient of resistivity? The change in resistivity per unit resistivity per unit rise in temperature. Is okay? Change in resistivity per unit resistivity per unit rising temperature is called temperature coefficient of resistivity. And this value will be different for different materials, like metals is different, semiconductors is different, even insulators is different. And this alpha value is positive for metals or conductors, whereas it is negative for semiconductors. It is negative for what? Semiconductors. And this positive for metals and negative for semiconductors or insulators. Is it? So let us see what is resistivity at any temperature. Rho T is equal to rho naught into 1 plus alpha delta T. Delta T is nothing but what? Change in temperature, which is delta T is equal to T2 minus T1, change in temperature, T minus T0. Actually, what do you get here? T minus T1, which is nothing but change in temperature. If T0 is equal to 0 degree Celsius, then T minus 0. But 0 degree Celsius will be converted into Kelvin, 273 K. Is it okay? So let me discuss how this depends upon resistivity, how does it changes with the temperature for metals and conductors and semiconductors. Which is important? For metals, what is the general formula for resistivity? Rho is equal to 1 by sigma, then sigma is equal to n square t by m. So what do you get here? M by n square t. Is it okay? M by n square t. Now for conductors, for metals, as the temperature increases, look at this one, what happens? There is no operational changes in the N. Is it? As the temperature increases, N will be almost same. Is it? That means number of electrons are remains same. Even very slight difference may be takes place. Slight increases may be takes place. But what happens to the relaxation time? Decreases. Tau reference, what here? Relaxation time decreases. Therefore, as the relaxation time decreases, what happens to this resistivity? Increases. Is it? Therefore, therefore resistivity increases with increasing temperature. For example, when you have taken for copper, what happens? The variation of the resistivity with the temperature T zero. So increases with increasing temperature. Here not linear, non-linear, but other physical somewhat now. Whereas for nichrome. So resistivity is right. Remember, we have manganese are constant in our nichrome. These are nothing but alloys. Alloys of these manganese are common. They are used to make a wire bond resistor. Why are they used to make a wire bond resistor? Because of they have coefficient, temperature coefficient of resistivity is very less. Means the variation of the resistivity with the temperature is very less, negligible. So that they are used in manufacturing of the wire bond resistors. Similarly, for insulators. For semiconductors or even for insulators, what happens? If the temperature increases, what happens? Number density of the electrons will be increased. However, relaxation time will be decreases. Is it? But remember, what is rho equal to? M by N E square T. Remember, in a semiconductor, the conductivity is due to the electrons and holes. And which we will discuss in the next further topics. We will have last topic 14th chapter, is it? So that what will happen whenever the temperature increases, the number density of the electrons or holes concentration will be changes compared to the decreasing resistivity, compared to decreasing the relaxation time, the increasing number density of the electrons will be more. Therefore, N value increasing in N is more compared to decreasing in relaxation time. Therefore, as the temperature increases, N value will increase, therefore the resistivity will be decreased. Therefore, for resistivity decreases temperature with increasing temperature. For what? Semiconductors are used. Let me take what we have back in the room. These are the room. What happens as the temperature increases? What happens to resistivity? Rho is equal to rho naught exponential decrease. Rho naught will be equal to minus kBT by m energy by 2e. Is it? That means here this resistivity is exponentially changes with the temperature. Exponentially changes with the temperature. So this is what we have seen about the variation of the resistivity. Similar as even resistance also. RT is equal to R naught into 1 plus alpha delta T. Our alpha is equal to R2 minus R1 by R1 into delta T. R2 minus R1. Because of this one you can see which type of the matrix are used in preparing the fuse wire. Alloy of tin and lead. Because of alloy of tin and lead is having high resistivity and low melting point. Melting point is very less, but resistivity is what? No. As the temperature increases, what happens to resistivity? Increases. Resistivity increases means what? More heat will be produced, then it will be melted. It will be as melting point. Even we have the electric heater. What is the principle in this one? As electric current flowing through that, then what happens to this temperature? Increases. As the temperature increases, resistivity will be increased. Like what? Nichrome. Is it? Even what type of the tungsten? nowadays we are not using filament bulb, filament which may be used as a filament in a bulb, silver bulbs, tungsten, which is having high resistivity and high melting. So these are somewhat used the materials based on the resistivity. Is it? In next class we discuss about some problems based, examples based on this resistivity, and thereafter we discuss about the resistors combination.